Vidar. Vidar. Luna. Come. Come on, Vidar. Come, boy. Luna.
That's my good boy. We've been doing. How's things going? Everything going okay, buddy? This is Vidar. He's a rock star Swedish Elkhound. He's up here with me today with Luna. We're training on the Desna work. And we were just over by the water. We had hiked all around that rim and came back across this ridge. And it's a little windy out there, so we're back down into here. But it's really pretty up here. We're somewhere around the 17th of July, I believe. And Vidar is the pup I'm training for that military man or woman. Special Ops, Special Forces, one of those guys down in the tunnel that's helping all those kids and getting rid of all the evil. He's turning to need some R&R time after they get that nasty job done. And this dog will, I'm going to gift this dog to that person. I don't know who that person is yet. I'm asking everybody to help me find out who that is and direct them to call me, because I'm going to give them this dog. I'm doing another about 3-4 weeks of training, so we have a month or so. If I can keep him longer, it's no problem. Luna, bring him here. Vidar, come by me, boy. Luna, come in the video for a minute. Vidar, Luna. Well, if they want to go that way, we'll go that way. That's okay. That won't affect our video at all, I don't think. I think we can go right down in there and film. Let me just move. Yeah, we'll go right here. I'll just set these legs a little bit different. Yeah, nothing wrong with that. I'll maybe tilt the back a little bit. Okay. That'd be pretty cool. You just stay down there, you guys. I got Luna training. She's an exceptional trainer. Her response time is almost immediate. She's very, very good. So she's excellent influence for that young guy. Now he's exceptional. I've watched his gait. His gait is perfect. He's got uncanny eye. He can see good. He watches things. His nose is excellent. He's a phenomenal dog. And so he's really personable, really handler focused. This is a good energy dog. He's a really good energy boy. He's got exceptional energy. He's a real good boy. This is a good healing dog, this guy. He'll make a world-class companion, that guy. He's fearless too, boy. Yeah. He's a really good dog. That's a Swedish Elkhound Jampen. Vidar. Now, Jens Mikkelsen. picked that name out. Phenomenal. A couple others suggested that too. And I had lots of good name suggestions, but I like that one. So yeah, well, the war is in full swing. The boys are wiping out the evil. We're trying to do what we can do up top. We're boycotting every cabal-owned, child trafficking-owned company, just not going near them, not ever going back in, go back in them, nothing. It's just we're calling all that crap out and getting rid of that up top. There'll be a lot of evil people getting hauled out, and we're sick and tired of it. No more of this crap. We were all sound asleep, me included. I mean, I was more awake maybe than my neighbor, but that doesn't mean anything. But I tell you, I lost respect for a lot of people. They got no brains. The Lord has closed their eyes and ears, and they can't see. And so it's a shame. But the good is prevailing, and the world's getting better. My world right here is fantastic. No more chemtrails. I haven't seen a chemtrail for a year and a half. All my wife saw 5 big jets going over this morning. Canada doesn't have fighter jets. So they're Allied Force jets, Allied Forces. And the other, not too long ago, saw 9 big cargo planes trucking over top of this direction. Must have been hauling prisoners. Although I don't think they're taking many, but they're taking some. But it's a whole new world. Now we got a little bit of smoke, but not too bad. The smoke is drifting this way and this way. So fire's on both sides of us. Now what we are seeing is a lot more game. So normally I know all the animals around here, and I don't see fox in this region, but I saw a big fox this morning. And had I had a couple of the big boys, he wouldn't be running. But it's not that they're against them. It's just that when I'm running with a pup, if I got the big males, an animal like that would be considered a threat, and they'd just snuff him out and hurry. The females might just give him a spook and chase him off, but the males, they're not going to tolerate that. So had I had Ark or something, and Vide or Ark would have just ran him down, you know, it'd be over in 30 seconds, but he just would have snuffed him out. Now the reason that I'm seeing these animals is they're getting pushed in here from the fire. So the regions that they're getting burnt out, they're moving in here. So we'll see way more bear. I saw a big buck the other day. He moved down from somewhere. The fox, we'll see a lot more. Now something's happened to one of my big ravens at home. I'm only seeing the old boy and no little guy. So the mom and the little guy must have something happened. That's kind of too bad. But you just stay right by me, mister, and say hello. How's my boy? You are such a fantastic boy. Nice is your good boy. Nice is your good boy. You're a good boy. You're a good boy. Yeah, he's a rock star, that guy. Total rock star. So the temp's way down today. It's still warm, but we're in the shade all the time. We're hiking shade all the time. We cross through a little bit of sunshine, but... And they ran deep in the water back there. It took just a big spring. So they're cooled off good. And we got a light breeze, so we can hike pretty good. He is an exceptional range dog. So he got trapped in the bush back there. I had went around, he went in, and he couldn't get through, and he couldn't see. So he called to me, which was pretty cool. Pretty cool. And he gave me a holler, and I said, well, come on around. And just stood where I was, and I kept telling him, come on around, come on around. And sure enough, he made his way back out and around and got right to me. Like, smart fella. Some would just battle their way through, but he turned and went back and came around. Each dog handles the situation like that a little differently. But he made her.
So yeah, it was pretty cool. She's a scorcher just the same though. But we had some way hotter days than this, but beautiful blue sky, not a cloud in the sky, not anywhere that you can see. I can get right up top here and look all the way around. Not one cloud. Yeah, pretty amazing. Look at how green and lush it is yet. Pretty good. We've had rain, right? So it's pretty nice. So yeah, these dogs here, if they're set up right, I'll tell you what, absolutely full-on loyal companion. Just incredible boys. Yeah, that's right. Jesus. You're a good boy. You're a good boy. You better come up and say hello. You better say hello. Glad to meet you. Yeah, really nice fella. Now that's a hunting dog, so he'd be hunting moose. He can hunt bear. Well, he can hunt anything you put him on. It's you can train them to hunt anything you want, but they like to hunt moose and they like to hunt bear. That's what they're really, really skilled at. They're extremely good at. And it's in them. It's not. It's, you don't have to do much. All you got to do is get where there is moose and bear. That's it. And they'll do the rest for you. Luna, you stay. Luna, stay. There's not much to getting one of these guys to hunt. It's not that difficult. It's right in them. So we're stopping game putting her all the time, of course. So they're hunting like they don't know that we're not hunting this time of year. They think they see one or smell one that they should be hunting now. So there's. I'm having to work a bit to keep them from stopping game all the time. But that's okay. They listen. But when you get this this type of dog focused and ready to work with the handler, and he's paying attention to the handler and focused on his range, then you see you can have trouble-free hikes all the time. Luna, you stay by me so he stays in the video. He'll bite my hat, sure as heck. That's right, you just stay by me and he'll stay in the video. Good girl. I raised Luna from a pup. Luna's a daughter of Dakota and Takwa. She's a full sibling to Mon and Tico. I have both them in the yard. Luna's an exceptional dog, very gifted female, one of the nicest females in North America, one of the most genetically diverse, that's a fact. Yeah. This is pure old world genetic, this dog. Exceptional dog. I have a daughter of hers, Revna, back in the yard. Yeah, I sat with Luna's mother when she was born, and I sat with Luna and Tekla had 10 pups the night of the supermoon. And Luna was one of them. Her and Mon and Tico and Ripley and Kronos and Max. And can't remember all the rest of them. Oh, hey. Nope. Vidar. You come. Vidar. You come here. No. You come here. Vidar. Come here. You come here. Good boy. Now that is pretty fantastic to leave that back. And come down here. That's pretty fantastic.
Unbelievable. He was tearing my back there and tipped her upside down and was great eating lunch. But he left it and came. Now that's pretty cool. That is focus. That is a good boy. That is a good boy. You are a total rock star, mister. Total rock star. You are some fantastic. You better come up here and get a big hug. Oh, you're a good boy. Oh, you're a good boy. Luna, what a good job you're doing with him. What a good boy. You are such a good boy. I can't believe it. I've seen a lot of things, buddy, but I don't think I've seen anybody as good as you. My goodness. Yeah, what a beautiful dog. Jesus. You are such a good boy. You are such a good boy. Did you know this is the first litter born in Canada that he's from that is from a female Yamtan born in Canada? This is the first litter. How's that? Pretty phenomenal. Oldest breed dog in the world, 10,000 year history or longer. And this is the first litter from a female born in Canada. That's pretty cool. This guy's father was born in Finland. He's in the yard. I brought him over as a pup. But this is a unique litter, this litter. Yeah, phenomenal dog. Good boy. Good boy. He'll be a nice big fella too. Really good boy. He's really doing good. They're growing like weeds now. I gotta feed him a little bit more by the looks of it, because he's outgrowing to feed. He's doing a pound in the morning and a pound at night, but I'll beat that up. Literally. I'll give him a pound and a half. Because they're running, they're working, it's hard for them. Luna, she's only on half a pound morning and night, and she could cut down. Luna's set of the old efficient dogs. Very easy on food. But she ain't growing, so that's totally fine. Well, that's a pretty good video. We're going to get hiking again. We'll go back to the water, and then we'll make our way back down that ridge. This was a good break. I'll have my lunch here and it's going to be good. It's 1 o'clock. Good. Good. Good video, you guys. Good video.